Hello and welcome. Here is the car doctor Peter Finn, and then I am planning to explain you, my friend, new interesting thing what some car manufacturers use, and this is really this oil cooler. And how works this oil cooler? And here is really one oil cooler, and inside of that area there is this oil filter. And normally oils go through that hole in here, and then it goes away in here, and also in that area oil is moving. And this part is bolted by engine block very near of cylinder head. And what is this purpose that we have in that area oil, and in this area goes coolant liquid? And what is this purpose that we have cooler in our oil filter? Okay, there is a situation that if we have very powerful engine, gasoline or diesel engine, this oil becomes hot. And normally oil can be in temperature what is like maybe 100 Celsius to this 150 Celsius. That heat is very high in oil. And then in same times when we have this coolant is lesser hot. It is about 50% of this oil hot. And that means now that if oil is like two times hotter than cooler, this coolant liquid, then this hot oil moves this heat to this lower heat and lower temperature cooling liquid. And idea is that when our engine is running, this oil is very hot, like this 100 Celsius, and it is like Fahrenheit about 200 Celsius or something like that. You can convert this in Google. And that means that in this area, engine oil, when engine is running, it is like 200 Fahrenheit. And then in same time, this our coolant liquid and radiator liquid, this is only 50% of that temperature. This is like then 100 Fahrenheit, and this oil is 200 Fahrenheit. And then this means in this thermodynamic laws, what is this physics, those science, it means that this heat moves in that area. And that means that then this our oil is not anymore this 200 Fahrenheit. It can drop something like 150 Fahrenheit, but then this coolant liquid, when it was like in the starting point, this 100 Fahrenheit, it became hotter, and this coolant is then 150 or maybe 120 Fahrenheit. And that means that when we have cooler oil, colder oil we have, and that means that what a lower temperature we have in this engine oil, then this oil lubricates our engine better. This is the point. Because if we have oil what temperature is lower than normally, then this oil works better. And this is the key point why we need to install and use these oil coolers. And then, my friend, you might think that in what cars we have these oil coolers. One of these very interesting car brand is this German make BMW car, and this is really BMW cars. And these BMW double cars are cars that are really complex, and they have really unique this engineering, and this unique engineering makes only lot of issues and defects. But when you have new BMW car, then all of these interesting things works. Because all time when we install new device like this cooler, there is risk that there is coolant leak in that area, in this area. And then we might have second issue that why our coolant liquid is low. But it is the another story, but this my current story is that what is this oil cooler and why we use that oil cooler. And thing is that this oil cooler makes this our car's engine temperature lower, and then when we have low temperature oil in our engine, this oil lubricates our engine better. An engine runs better and it gives more power, and also this parts wear out, wearing, and this how much parts burn out, it is lesser and less. Okay, and then my friend, we can also look this how to disassemble this oil cooler, and please enjoy and let's continue. And this opening is more safer when we install this cooler in workbench in that way, and a little bit compress that my cooler in here, and now it's in position. Okay, now it's in position, and then I take this my tool and it fits in these screws. There is four of these screws, and now I open that, and now I use my this electric drill driver. And my friend, I can recommend this tool. This is excellent for bolt opening, and you can purchase this tool from Amazon.com. And this is Makita drill driver DTD171, excellent tool. And now I install this my drill bite in here, and then I open, and there is this first nut. It looks like that. And then 7 second nut, and then that one, and there is fourth nut in here. And now this my bolts are open, and we can look that closer. Okay, and now when I have take these screws away, there is only one in here left. That area. Now it is also open. Then I can take this my oil cooler away, and there is really idea that oil goes through that hole in here and then this hole away. Really interesting this heater, this exchanger, and in that area there is going this coolant liquid. What takes this heat out, and then this oil goes this hot engine heat in. And this mixture happens in these different areas. Look, that coolant goes in this area, and oil goes in that area. And also in that area. And then when we look in this area, this is like oil filter area. And oil goes through that hole, and that hole, and that hole. And then we can also look this oil filter. And I open this my oil filter. But then we go in forward, because I need to open this cap hat. And I install this my pliers in long, and then opening direction in that way. And then little bit force, I compress this hard and move. And now this cap hat opens, then I need to only rotate that little bit. And there is really this BMW oil filter, and I can take that filter out. This is this idea. And same way this closing, when I close that my oil filter, in that way, firstly using my fingers. Then final part is that I take my pliers and then almost same amount in that way. And then when it stops, then we can think that now BMW's filter cap hat is in fine and in right position. And when we start our engine, we need to only check that there is no any oil leak in that area. And if we see some oil leaks, then we have to replace this gasket, what is in inside that plastic cover. Okay, that kind of information, my friend, and see you in next movie.